this, your boy Al Michael. Welcome to a brand new Comic Crusader special. Today, we're gonna be talking about that hot box. You know what box I'm talking about? That is Redbox. It's hot. It is sizzling. I mean, the last couple of episodes, it seems that you guys be loving that box. I mean, you know, of course, you got that big Redbox. You know, they're all over the streaming platforms as well, and your TV and everywhere for those that have that wonderful internet. And you know who's here to share what's going to be dropping this month? The one and only, the king of the streams. You know what I mean? The one that is cooking and making that box hot. Let me introduce Mr. CW, Mr. Chris Woosley, baby. How you doing?
I am great. Thanks for having me on board, Al Mega.
Wepa, no, thank you for coming, brother. You know what I mean? And a close. This is, you know, our fourth episode of the month. You know what I mean? Where we're talking about what the whole, you know, Chicken Soup for Soul family has, you know what I mean? And this is it. I mean, and like I told you before in the green room, Redbox seems to be popping with the fans. It seems to be a platform of their, like, they're very curious about what's going on. They want to stay tuned. This one is really on fire. So, you know, are you bringing me more fire this month, Chris?
That I am. There's always more fire at Redbox.
Wepa, and just like me, being unstoppable, what's going on here? Who else is unstoppable besides me?
Okay, so March is Women's History Month, so we wanted to spotlight with our titles this month a few women that have made incredible impacts. Unstoppable is actually the Bethany Hamilton story. You might remember a while back, she was surfing in Hawaii, and a shark took her arm off. She not only survived, recovered, but came back to become a professional surfer.
Insane.
And an amazing testimony of faith and perseverance. She's inspiring to me. I mean, I know people who have met her, and they said she is the real deal. Like, not only is she one of the kindest people that they've ever met, but just hearing her story and what she persevered through, just incredibly.
Imagine. I don't want to imagine having your arm bitten off by an animal. That must be insane. I don't want to know. But a salute to her. I see it. I mean, folks, we can see it right there. Like, wow. I mean, and to come back. You know, that term unstoppable, it's very true, folks. So, you know, whatever your dream, your passion, you know, it's never too late. You know, just, you know, if you don't try, you never know.
There you go.
All right. So let's get it done. Now let's get, you know, back on theme over here with Black. Oh, wow. Holy crap. Look at these names there. Blackbird. What's this? Holy smokes.
Quite a cast. Susan Sarandon. Sam Neill again keeps popping up, which is fine with me because he's one of my favorite actors. Anson Boone from 1917, which is an amazing movie. But this is Kate Winslet. I mean, it's pretty much endless. Rainn Wilson, one of the nicest guys in Hollywood. This is a beautiful film. So Susan Sarandon plays a woman who is kind of coming to the end of her life and wants to make sure that she has crossed all the T's and dotted all the I's in her life. And so she calls her family together for a kind of an impromptu family reunion where they can kind of work out all the kind of unsaid issues that are going on in the family. It's a beautiful film. Performances are through the roof. I don't know how no one in this film was nominated for anything because it is pretty outstanding. And I would watch Susan Sarandon read the phone book. So,
she's a great actress for sure. Absolutely. Amazing. Things you can tell just by looking at her. And if you're a man, please don't assume anything by looking at her.
Right? Exactly. Because you don't know. And that's exactly what this movie talks about. It's just... again, star-studded, Glenn Close, Cameron Diaz, Calista Flockhart. It's a list. star-studded. And it just talks about the complexity of the female experience, how, you know, we think that just by looking at somebody, we can tell so much about them. But really, you've got to look behind the scenes to see what's really going on.
Yeah, there we go. And then we got House of Glass.
You know, we've talked about this before. I love films. Well, first of all, I love thrillers. And I also love films where women are kind of taking things in their own hands.
Oh, yeah.
This one is really tense. So
look at her. She look like she don't give a crap about anything. Smoking her throat. She's like, go ahead, guy, try me.
Yeah. Scared. So it's about a suburban housewife who discovers something about her husband that she would rather not know, and as she continues to dig into what's actually going on, things escalate and intensify, and this one will definitely have you sitting on the edge of your seat.
You see that? Typical woman. Something she'd rather not know but continues to dig in. What are you doing? Stop it.
It's like that scab that you just can't stop picking at, you know?
Let me tell you what that, I'm telling you, she looks serious. All right, I want to see this because I could only, I got to tell my ex-wife about this one too because I did this right up her alley.
It's good stuff. Yeah.
All We Had. Oh, Cameron again. Oh, Katie Holmes, actually. Hey, look.
Yeah, yep.
Wow.
And in my opinion, this is one of her best performances. I've always thought that she was an underrated actress. And I think she's spectacular and she's really good in this movie. So it's a struggling mom. She's just clinging to life by the tips of her fingernails, trying to keep her daughter with her. They're going through a really tough season. And it's a beautiful portrayal of what a mom is willing to do to make a better life for her child. It's really a great film.
I gotta check. I mean, again, you know, I love stories about strong women, or being raised by one, you know, being married to one, and and being a father to one.
There you go.
You know, Bella Thorne. Oh, I love this girl. I think she's amazing. I think she has such a great future in acting. For real. And this, yeah. I mean, a red hair.
Have you seen this one?
No, I have not, because I haven't seen everything she's done. I've been catching lately a couple of things she's done, and I'm like, wow, she's grown up to become really good in the roles that she takes on. I'm like, whoa, she's
so great in this film. I cannot say enough good things.
You got Mickey Rourke in it too. All right, wait a minute, yo.
Yeah, I'm telling you, I know what you're watching tonight.
Yo, yes,
I am. So good. It's so good. So this is. It's got beautiful Bella Thorne. It's a revenge movie. It's got Mickey Rourke. It's great. She plays a girl returning to confront her abusive father in the small town where she grew up, arrives only to find out that someone has already taken care of the job for her. And she starts digging into his family. And kind of like with House of Glass, the more she digs, the more evilism is uncovered, and she decides that she's going to take care of this situation herself.
Basically,
it's really good.
Love it. Basically, the mission continues nonetheless.
Exactly.
She looks kick-ass in this poster. Yeah, I love. She did some movie. Damn, I forget the title, but she was like really great in it. I'm like, whoa. I mean, this is the same guy I used to watch, my daughter used to watch, our little kids. So, like, wow, the way they grew up and become really good, you know, again, the next generation, right?
That's it.
Emma Watson, talking about another great actress.
Yes. Shit. So, this was one of her first movies after the Harry Potter movies were done. And I think this was just her wanting to really be like, hey, I'm a serious actress. Yes, I made these movies that millions of people adore, but I can do more than that. And it's great. It's political intrigue, loosely based on real events. in South America. It's very good. Her performance is award winning. It's great.
I'm sure these young kids, man, you know, growing up now, they're only getting better. Oh man, Jessica Biel, wepa.
Right? That's what you're talking about right there. Yeah. Bleeding Heart. It's sort of a female action film, but with a real heart, hence the name. But you've got Jessica Biel, and she has to rescue. She discovers that her sister is involved in the sex trade, and decides that she is going to get her out at all costs. And it does cost her just about everything, but it's a beautiful story, and yet it's got some heart pounding action in there as well.
Gotcha. Yeah, I love that, man. Great actress, Violet and Daisy. Yo, what is it with these posters? Yeah, this one scares me too.
It should. So, Saoirse Ronan from Lovely Bones, and yeah. Alexis Bledel from Gilmore Girls, who played the daughter in Gilmore Girls. Okay. It is really good. We were talking about The Professional in an interview a couple weeks ago, and this has a very similar feel to The Professional. These two girls play teenage hit girls. Oh. And so they get a job to go take this guy out. And when they arrive, they discover that it's actually the guy is played by James Gandolfini, who, interesting sub story or tangential story. Did you know, Al, and I doubt you did because I didn't until he told me, that our mutual friend David Matalon, who wrote Totally Killer, discovered James Gandolfini.
Stop lying.
I am not lying. So Dave was doing his NYU film project in the late 80s, and James Gandolfini was the bouncer at the bar he would go to every night. And he said, James, would you consider being the lead in my student film? And James was like, hey, I'm not an actor. I'm just, I'm a mook. I'm just a bouncer. Dave convinced him to be the lead in his movie, and that was the start of James Gandolfini.
Wow.
Yeah.
I mean, his son looked just like him, too.
Yeah, he's a good little actor, man. He's coming up. Man.
You know, much love and success in the future. All right, totally. But you got me on this, though.
So anyway, yeah, these girls show up, and they find out that this job that they thought was going to be cut and dried is way more complicated than they ever hoped. And it's very, very interesting film.
Well, I can't wait. All right. Shit, man. My weekend's piling up. Oh, I remember this bad boy right here.
Yeah. Very fun stuff. Bulletproof Monk. I am a gigantic Chiyun Fat fan.
Hard-boiled.
And I've got to say, Sean William Scott, you know, he could have just been like, pretty boy number 97. But, dude, he's got comedy chops. He's a funny guy.
Action chops, because he did the Lethal Weapon TV series replacing the other homie. And not for nothing, he actually did a really great job in replacing him.
Yep, I think he's fantastic. He's great in this. This is super funny. It's it reminds me of Eddie Murphy. Do you remember Golden Child?
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, this is kind of the reverse of Golden Child. So you have this like this monk who has lived this austere lifestyle, and then he has to go to New York City in the like depth of all the nastiness and runs into this kid who's just goofy and doesn't understand the world that he came from. It's super fun.
Yeah, absolutely. Yes, absolutely. And then we got a classic.
Classic.
It is the season. You know, spring is almost here. Pitchers are called up already in catches. Yo, Bull Durham, what timing, you guys, naughty you guys, making us get ready.
Right.
Spring air.
Pitchers and catchers report, and Redbox rolls out the baseball classics. This is one of my all-time favorite movies. I mean, it's so great. Susan Sarandon again. Obviously, Kevin Costner, a legend. And Tim Robbins, in my opinion, maybe his funniest role of his career. Also one of his first roles. Everybody's so young in this movie, it's ridiculous. It makes me feel old. But if you love baseball, if you love comedies, just watch this movie. It's so good.
It is an absolute classic. Definitely gotta watch. And oh man, my big homie Michael J. White over here. What? And it's a dude. Oh shit! This is Layla's first flick.
Yeah.
Get out.
Yeah, it's great. Super fun action film. He hit the scene, and you were just like, "Who is this guy? And how can I watch every movie he ever makes? He's just awesome." And starring Neil McDonough, who also lives down the street from me, and I'm hoping to run into him. I keep trying to stalk him, but
Chris keeps jogging every day at a certain time.
Well, our kids go to the same high school, so I keep going to all the parent nights, hoping Neil's gonna be there. But
who cares what the teachers are talking about? Where's this guy at?
Exactly. So I have not run into him yet, but I've got fingers crossed. So anyway, this is your Friday night popcorn action flick.
It is awesome. Thank you. You definitely got my weekend planned. I'm digging it as always. You know, Redbox, you know, keeping it hot. And again, folks, just like every other channel, this is not just it. He's only coming here giving us a tease. Just a little sprinkling. You know, of what's available. There's so much content that would definitely, I mean, and it's not just for you guys or not just for you girls. It's, you know, overall for the family as well. There's all types of content. You know what I mean? So you got those Friday night, you know, evening zizzlers with you and your shorty. But then you got those afternoon, you know, before bedtime films to watch with the kiddies. You know, that way you get them tired and then you can put them kids in bed and watch some good stuff, all right? So, you know, keep it hot on Redbox. It's free, redbox.com. You can get the app available absolutely everywhere. Absolutely no excuse for you not to have this free app. You hear me? All right, Chris, as always, an absolute pleasure to have you on and sharing your energy, your passion with all this stuff. I mean, I can't imagine if you just, you know, perusing and watching all this stuff. Thank you for letting us know what we need to stay in touch with and more.
Al, being on your show is without a doubt the highlight of my month. Thank you so much for having me back week after week. This is amazing.
Nah, yeah. Listen, you're the boss, kiddo. Much love. Thank you for the whole, Chicken Soup for Soul family, allowing you to be on the platform and sharing in the greatness. And folks, thank you most of all for tuning in. You know what it is? Follow everything Redbox, everything Chicken Soup for the Soul. All the links are below. I make it easy. And with that, much love. Hasta la próxima. Redbox!